So now let's look at what kinds of faults can we have. We can classify the faults by cause, and we can have a hardware fault when the hardware of the system fails to perform as it was designed to do. We can have design faults. For example, software bugs are design faults, and also some of the hardware design mistakes, such as the famous Pentium FDIV bug, where this FDIV instruction was not implemented correctly. So if you gave it some combinations of numbers, you would get incorrect results, and it was designed that way. Then we have operation faults, for example, operator and user mistakes. For example, the operator accidentally tells the system to shut down, and now, of course, it no longer provides the service that it's supposed to provide. And then we can have environmental faults, such as fire that burns down the system, power failure, sabotage of the system, all things that in the environment may cause the system to have an error or not perform the service. Note that these are all faults. Some of them don't result in a failure. For example, the FDIV bug doesn't result in an error or a failure if you never really use the wrong combination of numbers for it. A software bug in a rarely used function may never result in an actual error. Operator faults may not cause the system to actually have an error. For example, if you shut down the system, but at this time, for example, nobody's trying to use it to get service from it, it might not be an actual failure. And then we can have a fire, but if we protected our system from fire, a fire in the system room may not actually result in an error. For example, we can have a switch over to another system. Power failure can be mitigated, so it can be a fault, but may not result in an error. For example, if our battery power supply lasts long enough to overcome the power failure, and so on. So again, these are faults according to their cause. Any of these faults might result in errors and subsequently failures, but for all of them, it is possible that we get a fault, but not an error or a failure. We can also classify faults by duration. For how long do we have the fault condition? For example, we can have a permanent fault. Once we have it, it doesn't get corrected. An example of a permanent fault is when we want to see what's inside the processor, and now the processor is in four pieces and we don't know how to put it back together. We can have intermittent faults. They last for a limited duration of time, but they are recurring. So it's not like we get this type of fault and for a while it causes things to not work fine, but then it just disappears and never comes back. This is something like every couple of seconds something happens. A good example of intermittent fault is when we overclock our system, it works fine, then crashes, then we reboot it, it works fine, it crashes, and so on. So for a while it works fine, but then the same type of problem recurs. And then finally we have the transient faults, which are when it lasts for a while, then just goes away. A transient fault is, for example, when an alpha particle hits the chip, so for a while it has all sorts of problems, but then once we reboot it, it's no longer going to have these problems and they're not going to occur again until, you know, much later when something else happens.